Hi, I'm Elian Saint-Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to take a look at MeshCentral support for device pages. So MeshCentral can be a server that you can connect a lot of devices to. And you can connect sometimes enormous amounts of devices to MeshCentral. And we're talking over 100,000 devices for a single MeshCentral instance. And so it's possible that if you connect that many devices, 100, 150,000 devices to MeshCentral, the server will work well, especially if you use a really good database. But the user interface will very much be terribly slow. And that's because now you'll have possibly 150,000 devices in a single account. And when you log in and take a look at those devices, the UI will be extremely slow to populate and to show the devices and to interact with. And so we need a way to view only a certain amount of devices at a time on the website and then kind of move between these devices. And that is what MeshCentral Pages is. So let's take a look at that. And so the first thing I'm going to do is start with a few slides. There we go. So what we're going to talk about today is the addition of these controls on the top of the desktop website and also on the mobile site. And so here it says page 1 of 3, and you can scroll back and forth between the pages. On the mobile site, you'll have 2 arrows. On the desktop side, you'll have also the go to the first page, go to the last page. And the idea is that if you have so many devices on your server that the page is slow to load, to render, to use, then this will be the solution for you. Now, just before I go into demonstrating this, I want to show or talk a little bit about the technical details behind this. Now, one would assume if you were a normal developer and you building a normal web application, that you would query the database and you would say to the database, I want a certain number of devices. Give me the first 100 devices. The database would then return those devices and you would give them to the web page to be displayed. And so that is true to some extent, but MeshCentral's web page is also a real-time web page. So what happens is that you get an event stream of stuff going on, devices connecting and disconnecting. You get users changing device names. You have the devices being reconfigured, AMT being activated, and so on and so forth. And so as this event stream comes in, it now has to be filtered based on only the devices that you're looking at. So if the database gave the web page, you know, 1,000 devices to look at, then what you want to do is also filter the event stream so that only the events for that 1,000 devices gets sent to the web page. And so that's really nice because if you have 150,000 devices, you want to limit how many events are being sent to the web page at any given time. And so what's going to happen here is that there's both a system to query the database and return the devices to be displayed on the page, but also the server will keep track for your session, for your specific session, for a given browser and a given tab. It will keep track of what devices have been shown to you so that when the event stream comes in with different events, the server knows how to filter those and only give you the correct ones. So that's how it's going to work. The other thing I want to note is that this feature is not on by default. You need to go into the domain section of the config.json and you add this line, max device view, and you put a number. This will be the maximum number of devices that a web page can display. Now, if a user has less than that number of devices being shown, then the page view mode is not enabled. So even if you put this value, you know, you put a value like 1,000 here, if you have less than 1,000 devices that are displayed in your account, then you won't see a single difference. The extra controls won't show up, and all the real-time events and stuff, they will all show up exactly like you're used to. But if you have more than that amount, then device paging and filtering will kick in, and MeshCentral will take care of adding these extra things. Okay, and so we'll do a demo in a second. Another thing I want to quickly mention before I jump to the demo is that if you are running really that many devices connected to your server, one thing you may want to consider is using MongoDB. And in MongoDB, there's a thing called, there's an option that MeshCentral supports called MongoDB bulk operations, and that will basically bunch up a bunch of read or write operations to MongoDB into single operations. So normally you want to write two records, you do write, then MongoDB says okay, you write the next one, you say okay. Well, if you put bulk operation turned on, MeshCentral will start basically bunching up all the operations that are the same, so all the read operations, all the write operations, and we'll do one single write or one single read operation with all of the operations in a single bulk operation. So that really does speed up your database access in MeshCentral a lot. It's not offered on any other database, only on MongoDB. Speaking of that, I want to mention one more thing. This entire feature of device pages is only available on the big major databases. So it's available on MongoDB, MySQL, MariaDB, Postgres, and also SQLite. It is not available on ASBase. It's not available on AnyDB. So even if you put this this max device view, you put a number here, if you're running at AnyDB, that's not gonna work. Okay, so hopefully that was all good for the slides. Now I'm gonna bring up my demo setup. I have, of course, my regular server here, and this is my developer server, and I have a bunch of machines on here. I can click on one, go to desktop, and of course everything works normally. Now I have about 35, 40 machines on this web page, so this is not something that would normally cause any issue, but we're going to still use the paging option on this little server to just show how it works. So what I'm gonna do is bring up my config.json, and I have a very simple config.json here. I happen to be using MongoDB. If I used SQLite, if I used MariaDB, MySQL, Postgres, any of those would work perfectly fine for this demo. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is in the domain section of the config.json, I am going to add this line, max device view, and I'm going to put 15 in my case. Now, normally, 200, 300, 400 would probably be just fine. And now, this is the maximum amount. In the future, I may have allowed a user to configure a smaller amount than that. But this would be the maximum allowable value that the server would send to a web page at any given time. So in the future, we may allow the user to set lower value. So I'm gonna set this to 15, and you'll notice here there's no controls yet. I'm gonna do Control C, run the server again. And of course the page auto reconnects. And now you see I'm on page 1 of 3, and I have my 4 buttons here. Now I'm seeing basically roughly 1/3 of the devices on the screen, and then I can click to go to the next page. I see the next second third, click the next page, I see the last third. And then I can go back and forth, go to the first one, go to the last one page, and so on. Now, if I go on a given page, I can click on a device, And you know, inside a device, everything's the same. So you get the same details, events, files. I can connect to desktop. I can do RDP, web relay. All these things all work. But when I go to the main device view here, I only see 1/3 of the devices. The other thing to note is that there's a group like this local group here. It says there's no device in this group, but that's because I'm in page 3. So you're always going to see all the device groups. They're all going to be there. But depending on which page you're on, you will see some device groups like local devices here has 4 devices on page 1. In page 2, it has none. And on page 3, it also has none. So what I want to point out is that here you have device groups, but depending on which page you're in, these may be populated or not. Okay, so that's one thing. The other thing is the filter here. This filter will only work for devices that you're currently looking at in the page. So basically, you know, sort of everything here, the sorting, you can sort by power state, by device and so on. Everything here works sort of the same as before, except that you're just receiving one fraction of the devices on the page. If you right-click on a group and say select all, you're selecting all the devices that you're seeing on that page, not all the devices for the entire device group. Now, I may continue improving this in the future, but this was kind of the sort of this simple operation. Keeps it simple on the server. But in the future, I may, when I do a sort here, I may have the database pre-sort and then change the filters on the backend. But right now, there's kind of no backend sorting, so to speak. So there are some limitations here. The other thing to note is that if a device gets removed, you will see it being removed from the web page, and you will see events like if devices connect and disconnect. But if a device is created, it may not show up on the website here. But it will show up if you switch pages and come back, then you'll see it. But it's not going to show up in real time anymore. And that's kind of normal. It's because you're looking at one page, and at that point, you don't know the new device, which page it will go in. So anyway, that's another limitation. But if you're dealing with thousands and thousands of devices, I don't think that matters much, that you're not seeing devices pop up immediately. However, the state of the devices, things like, for example, if I change a device name, like, for example, I'll duplicate this tab. This tab here, and so I can go on page 2 on here, and then click on Central, and change the name of the device, and that will work. But of course, if I'm not looking at this web page right now, if I'm on page 1 and I change this, then this does change correctly, but this browser does not receive the event. Now, when I switch to the other page, then it will, you'll see it correctly, but it's not real time, from this page's perspective. Okay, so hopefully that made sense. The other thing I want to show is the mobile website. So I am going to duplicate this tab again. And then I'm going to put mobile equal 1 as an argument on the website. And you'll see here, this is about what the mobile site looks like on a phone. And you'll see on the top, there's the controls. And I can switch between pages. And of course, once I find a device I'm interested in, I can do remote desktop, connect, and take a look at the controls. At the remote desktop on my phone or on my mobile device. So that's pretty cool. Anyway, I hope that was clear. Basically, this is going to be super useful for people with lots and lots of devices on their servers, with accounts that have, probably over 1,000 devices. Most likely, the number of devices, the maximum number of devices you want to show is probably around 1,000. After that, you probably want to start enabling paging mode so that the user's browser is not swamped with devices. Hopefully that was clear. Thank you very much and have a great day.